It is high time that the people of South Africa must know that from 2009, when Pravin was made the Minister of Finance, he was the biggest enabler of state capture. He was the biggest defender of Jacob Zuma. Yes. And we have since sent him questions of all the activities that he was engaged in before 2009 when he was made the Minister of Finance. Before 2009, in terms of political standing, Pravin Gordhan was nothing. And many people were surprised as to why did he become the Minister of Finance. I'm going to tell you today, it's because he had a private intelligence in SARS called the Rogue Unit. He is the one who gathered the so-called spy tapes. He is the one who used those tapes to go and bargain with Jacob Zuma to say that we'll give you the tapes, drop your corruption charges, and then you must appoint me as the Minister of Finance. We know as a matter of fact today of a meeting which Pravin organized between Jacob Zuma, Ivan Pillay, Obama Hashule, and others to talk about the deal of making Pravin Gordhan the Minister of Finance. And it is not true that Pravin was not working with the Guptas. On many occasions, he met with the Guptas. He only came to disclose now when we dropped Tantanene. Pravin Gordhan was the biggest fundraiser for Jacob Zuma to be re-elected as ANC president in 2012 in Mangaung. All the evidence that is coming about Nazareth, the person who went to white monopoly capital to get money to finance Cyril Ramaphosa's campaign is Pravin Gordhan. He's acting like he's an angel. We've got all the information.